गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन. यस्टरडे वी हैव स्टार्टेड अवर न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज़ हीट एंड टेम्परेचर एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विद द रेस्ट ऑफ द टॉपिक दैट इज़ चेंज ऑफ स्टेट. सो वट इज़ द स्टेट ऑफ मैटर? फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट इज़ स्टेट ऑफ मैटर इज ऑफ थ्री टाइप्स, दैट इज सॉलिड, लिक्विड एंड गैस. The intermolecular force of attraction between the gas molecules are very loose and the intermolecular force of attraction between the liquid is little bit weak. Solid have strong force of attraction between their molecules. So all the materials in nature are made up of molecules that are always in motion. So in solids, molecules are arranged in an orderly manner with the fixed position, you can see in this picture, and these molecules keep vibrating around their mean positions. So the molecules of solids do not have the freedom to move their position due to intermolecular force of attraction between them, as I told you earlier. So the molecules of liquids are closer to each other and thus those of gas. So the intermolecular force between them is less in comparison to solid and is greater in comparison to that in gas. In this picture, you can clearly see the changes in the state of matter. First of all, solid melts to form liquid and liquid again evaporates to form gases. And gases after the reversible sublimation again form the solid state. In this way, the same way, again the process of which needs an increase in the temperature in order to be carried out, again it will go on like this and the state of matter will change. So this is only called a state of matter, okay, and its changes. Now we are going to see about chemical and biological changes. So many chemical changes are possible only on heating. When we mix iron pieces with sulfur powder, no chemical reaction takes place, and when we heat this mixture, then iron sulfide is formed. This shows that for any chemical change, heat is only responsible. So heat energy is produced in some chemical changes. For example, on mixing limestone with water, okay, 37 degrees Celsius temperature is suitable for the mammal cell and 40 degrees Celsius for birds. This is the reason that for the development of eggs, it is necessary to warm them and to keep them at a comfortable and steady temperature. So remember students, whenever the change that produce a new substance, that is only called chemical change. Now we are going to see about the measurement of heat. We have studied that heat is an energy whose effects causes the temperature of an object to increase. So 1 calorie heat is amount of heat that increases the temperature of 1 gram of water by 1 degree Celsius. That is, you can see in this picture, 1 calorie equals to 4.186 joule. Again, I am repeating, 1 calorie equals to 4.186 joule. That is, 1 calorie heat is the amount of heat that raises the temperature of 1 kg of water by 1 degree Celsius. Our next topic is thermometer. You all are familiar with the thermometer. It has one end of the tube has a bulb made up of thin glass filled with mercury, and mercury is in the liquid state. The other end of the glass tube is sealed after removing air from it. You can see in this picture, temperature divisions in Celsius or in some other units are marked on the tube. The SI unit of temperature measurement is degree Celsius, and in the thermometer, mercury is generally used as the liquid for temperature measurement, as I told you earlier. The reason for this are as follows. Mercury is a shiny and non-transparent liquid. This means it can be seen very easily from the outside of the glass. It does not stick to the glass walls and it remains in the form of liquid for a large range of temperature. Freezing point, that is 39 degrees Celsius, and boiling point 357 degrees Celsius. Its rate of expansion remains the same for almost all the temperature. Okay, so in thermometer, divisions are marked from 0 degrees Celsius, that is freezing point of water, and 100 degrees Celsius, that is boiling point of water. But for using the thermometer, there are certain precautions which need to be seen. So first of all, thermometer should be washed before and after use, preferably with an antiseptic solution. Secondly, ensure that before use, the mercury level is below 35 degrees Celsius. Read the thermometer, keeping the level of the mercury along the line of sight. Handle the thermometer very carefully. If it hits against some hard object, it can break, and don't hold the thermometer by the bulb while reading it. Okay, so these are the few of the instructions and precautions for using thermometer. Students, almost we have completed our chapter. Next class, you are going to get the question answers of this chapter. Till that time, thank you.